Welcome back to another edition of OFB TV postseason. John Keeley here, and it's now a 2-0 Capitals lead over the Rangers in this first round of the playoffs in 2011. I am joined tonight by Ted Starkey, to my right, of the Washington Times, and Jack Anderson of Sirius Satellite Radio. And guys, the great news is it's better to be up 2-0 than down 2-0, but it's the Washington Capitals we're talking about. So what does it mean, Jack?
Well, basically, they have blown 2-0 series leads the last two times they've had them, so they're really going to need to make sure they have that killer instinct follow through in games 3 and 4 on the road. I mean, if they can salvage a split, that's something I'm sure they'd like to see. Better yet, maybe even get the sweep. Jason Arna tonight said, along with several other veterans, that they really, you know, weren't pleased with their play in the third period. They thought playing the neutral zone wasn't, you know, what they wanted it to be. It was a little bit sloppy. So if they can tighten that up, I would expect them to get a split at least on the road.
Jack makes a good point about the third period here tonight. It didn't look good. I thought the Caps really sagged too much. The Rangers had control. Bruce Boudreau said the puck was in our end the whole third period. Is that a trouble marker headed up to New York, or are the Rangers so offensively challenged that they can't really pose a challenge to this team?
I thought, the Rangers kind of held the play. They tried to get a little bit more physical, but I thought, you know, the Rangers need Marian Gabbert to score, and he hasn't done a whole lot this series. He's had two good chances, one in game one, one in game two, and Neuvirth has stoned him both times. And, you know, if the Rangers have a chance in the series, they need Gabbert to score.
Well, you're talking about one player there. Is there a line? Have we seen a line yet from the Rangers in two games in this series that poses a threat to this Capitals club?
Well, any line Boyle's been on has been fairly effective, but at the same time, you know, when he's playing with Wolski really isn't physical enough to, you know, take what the Capitals are dishing out in terms of taking the body. And Brandon Prust hasn't been, he's been kind of invisible. I really think, you know, it's something, he helped set up their only goal of the series, but after that, he really has been invisible. They're going to need people like that to help Gabrick and other guys set them up, you know, get them scoring chances.
Yeah, I've liked Boyle, the way he's looked, a big physical guy. But of course, on the defensive side of things for the Rangers, their top pairing here, a lot of minutes. Yep. And I see them getting worn down because I don't see their minutes decreasing as we go back to New York. Yep. And here's maybe the big problem, and I think I'm going to write about this. The Capitals now don't just have a good and effective first line and a good and effective second line. They, tonight, as we saw, got production from the third unit, super speed.
Yes.
I mean, speed that kills. And they're going to throw, Bruce Boudreau's going to keep throwing these lines. And you look at the shifts that they took tonight and the minutes that were spread out among these guys, there's a lot of balance. I don't see how the Rangers' blue line can keep up with this wave.
Well, it was interesting for the Rangers that Matt Gilroy, who scored a goal for the Rangers in game one, got burned twice tonight. The Caps' first goal, Brooks Lank was behind the net. Muscle Gilroy to send it in front to Johansson, who sent it in front to Chimera. Second goal, the fluky, as Bruce Boudreau called it, fluky. John Tortorella called it unfortunate, depends which side you're on. But the puck went right off his stick, right to Jason Arnott. Arnott admitted after the game he was kind of lucky to be there, but he was glad to put the puck in the net. And, you know, Gilroy's a young kid, and the Rangers are having to rely on those guys. And, you know, Caps have a lot of offensive talent, and they really took advantage of that.
We probably all agree the Caps lineup is going to stay the same for Game 3. Why would you make any changes?
Yeah, well, you know, some people are saying Eric Fair, but why take Jason Chimera out? Jason Chimera was great on the forecheck, very physical, scored a goal.
Right.
Was, you know, that was one of the most beautiful Caps goals I think we've seen all season. The setup was great. Hannon gets it in deep. Likes physical behind the net, gets it over to Johansson, and Johansson sets up Chimera perfectly in the slot for that goal. It was beautiful.
All right, so I don't think we need to focus on the Caps. I mean, you don't change your dance partner if the dance is going great. So let's say we're John Tortorella. Game 3, Sunday afternoon, Madison Square Garden. What are you doing with, if anything, with the lineup? What can you do? Chris Drury, he's invisible to me. Gabrick is up and down all year.
Yep.
They badly are missing Callahan.
Yep.
What do you do to try to change this up? Now, late tonight, we saw them trying to make mischief.
Right.
Maybe they try to goad the Capitals into penalties, but so far the Capitals are being disciplined.
I think the important thing for the Rangers in Game 3 is, you notice in Game 1, they took the lead, they were able to play their game. The problem is, once the Caps scored the two quick goals tonight, it took the Rangers out of their game. You know, they wanted to sit back, they wanted to kind of let the, you know, kind of clog up the neutral zone and let the Caps try to take shots from outside. But you can't do that when you're playing from behind, especially by two goals. You know, it wasn't just 1-0, it was 2-0. It was really difficult for the Rangers to come back from that. So I think if you're the Rangers, you want to feed off the home crowd, throw the kitchen sink at Neuvirth. You know, it's a tough place to play for an opposing goaltender, and try to get the lead, because if you don't get the lead, then, I mean, if you remember the 2009 series, Game 6 was similar. The Caps had come here, shut out, the last shutout the Caps had was Game 5 of the 2009 series. Series shifted back to New York. Rangers got a quick goal, but then the Caps, I believe, scored four goals right after that. Like, some lightning quick goals, and it just took the crowd out of it.
Something's going to have to give on Sunday, because the Capitals are a really good road team. They just seem more relaxed on the road and in sync. The Rangers are a good home team. At least they were toward the end of the season when they needed to be. So something's got to give. I agree with you, Ted. They got to throw the kitchen sink at the Capitals. Got to try to draw some penalties. Yep. They're not scoring 5-on-5. They're not scoring, period, but 5-on-5, they have no chance, it seems, yep, against this lineup. I don't see it being particularly optimistic here if I'm a Blucher.
I don't know how it can be either. The Capitals are playing the Rangers' physical game, outplaying them, and they have more scoring talent. If the Capitals get leads in this series, we saw it tonight. The Rangers tried everything they could. They only got 9 shots in the second period, and the Caps didn't even play a great game defensively in the third.
We're not going to book our tickets, though, for the next round because
it's the Capitals.
But, hey, folks, it's good to be in this position. So we'll be back at it and have some commentary for you after Game 3. It's going to be a lot more fun going up there. Anyway, for OFB TV, I want to thank Ted Starkey, The Washington Times, and my new friend here, Jack Anderson, Sirius Satellite Radio. And we will see you next time.